Big new film hitting cinemas today, so let's bring in Australia's toughest film critic. It's Jono Coleman, everyone.
Thank you very much indeed. Thank you. Thank you very much.
What's up first?
Well, I've been going to see lots of movies, and today some great movies are coming out. Some great, some not so great. But first up, it's Colin Firth's latest movie. It's called Kingsman, not Kingsmill the Bread. It's Kingsman, and it's the Secret Service, and it's very sort of now. It's a bit of a spoof of a James Bond, and it's kind of like the Knights of the Round Table, and it's like they recruit a bit of a bother boy from the streets of North London or East London. Take a look at a bit of a clip. We'll talk more about it.
Oh, yes. Very, very nice.
Your weapon scores are excellent, by the way. These you're familiar with, and this is our standard issue pistol. It's quite unique, as you'll see. It also fires a shotgun cartridge for use in messy, close range situations. How do they feel?
Yeah, good.
Now do your very best impersonation of a German aristocrat's formal greeting. No, exactly.
That is sick.
So it's aimed at a youth market. Mm. So if you like the movie Kick-Ass or Kick-Ass or X-Men Days of Future Past, same director.
It's based on a comic book, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah, it's one of those Marvel comic books again.
Fantastic.
And it's kind of like it's a sort of spoof, tongue-in-cheek, and Samuel L. Jackson's a great sort of nasty villain who wants to take over the world. It's a bit Austin Powers, but the gadgetry is fantastic. So, and it's also very violent, so I wouldn't, you know, it's not exactly a fun family movie, but boys will love it, teenage boys. They'll be grunting to themselves for days and days to come.
What's your rating?
My rating is 4 Chock Tops.
Oh,
I liked it,
right.
And I think it's fantastic. It's actually, the screenplay is written by Jonathan Ross's wife, Jane Goldman, who's almost now more successful than he is. So go and see that one. That's out today. That's called Kingsman, as opposed to Kingsmill. The second movie I'm talking about is also The Gambler. This is a remake of the 1974 James Caan film, or James Caan film. And you've got all the good people in there. Mark Wahlberg, of course, and John Goodman. And Laura Dern there, playing his mum. But I just found that I didn't really care about any of the characters. I didn't really get into it. Like, the James Caan movie, 1974, had a lot more guts, a lot more storyline. This is all kind of... He's one of those guys who gets... He's $2 million ahead and he puts it all on black. And you kind of go, what an idiot. It's, and he's trying to pay back all these people that he owes money to, including John Goodman. And he goes, I haven't got your money. And you know he's going to get beaten up. So it's sort of annoying in a lot of ways.
Isn't that why it's called The Gambler?
Yeah, he's The Gambler, but it doesn't really send out a good message about the gambler. At least in the James Caan version, there was more of a message. He's like a university professor who's written a book that's successful, but he's actually a serial gambler, and he just knows he's going to get beaten up by this gangster or that gangster, and it's annoying in some ways. And I just didn't believe. I didn't get involved with the whole. I got more involved with Kingsman, and that was completely spoofed.
It's a bit judgy, Jono.
Oh, thank you.
Well, how many chock tops?
Only 3 chock tops, I'm afraid. If you really if you want to see the proper story, go and see the original.
Give it 2 then, if you think it's pretty average.
I didn't want to be too nasty.
You are so generous with your chocolate.
He's a critic. He's the critic with a heart.
Yeah. I'm the critic with a heart.
What a diet.
And a heart condition. No, just joking about that. Anyway, as we always say in these kind of segments, I'll see you at the snack bar.
Oh, thanks, Jono. I love that.
They're all out today. I'll be nasty next week.
We will. Sorry.
I was just going to say, you should get Jono to come on Shark Tank and he just stand at the door just giving money away.
Yeah.
You don't want a chocolate?
Now, there's an idea.
Here's another 100 grand.